on behalf of my friends and family, I want to welcome you and thank you for taking your precious time to join us in this special wake-up service in memory of the worship Johnny Adigwe Owodu, who passed on to be with the Lord on November 7, 2015 in Atlanta, Georgia. I thank each of you for coming to encourage, to comfort the Owodu family, his children, his brothers and sisters, all of his friends, comrades, and the community of Atlanta. We all mourn together in this great loss. We thank you for coming to share your love and to share your hope with the bereaved family, with the bereaved community, with the Asaba community, with the Anyama community, and with the Nigerian community in Atlanta. I pray that God will comfort us all together tonight, that God will extend his healing hand and dry our tears and fill us with joy and hope, knowing that one day we will also meet our brother in heaven, because he has gone into heaven to be in the very presence of God. At this time, if I may, to ask you to stand as we begin with a quick opening prayer and hope. Dear Heavenly Father, our God and our Creator, our eyes are full of tears tonight and blinded by the symbols of sorrow and grief and agony over the passing of our dear brother, Chief Oweshi Johnny Adigwe Owodu, who passed on to be in the very presence of you. Our jaded hearts are sore with grief and sorrow and suspense as we wait in the twilight of an excruciating uncertainty of where our brother has come. We ask you to fill us tonight with your love as we seek to understand the explanation of death and mystery of death and what has happened to our brother and friend. Our Father, our uncle. Our faces tonight are filled with measure, with loneliness, with sorrow, with tears. May we call upon you tonight, merciful God, to give us your love, to show us your grace. We need you tonight. Forgive all of our sins and strengthen us, even as we memorize our brother tonight. And wish him well, to rest well in the heaven. Comfort the bereaved family and give all of us the fortitude and the strength to bear this huge loss. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who reigns and lives forever and ever. Amen. You remember before you this day our brother Johnny Adigwe Owodu. We thank you for giving him to us, his family, friends, to know and to love him with so much compassion, especially during this earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us to mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in perfect confidence, we may continue our course on earth until by our call we are reunited with those who have before through Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. At this time, I'll call on Mr. Ibe to read our first scripture reading.
This is the first reading from the book of Thessalonians. Brothers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep, or to grieve like the rest of the men who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in Him. According to the Lord's own word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are still left till the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord Himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so will we be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage each other with those words.
Stand as we sing the hymn, "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross."
O sons of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. You sweep men away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning, though in the morning it springs up new, by evening it is dry and withered.
Man, thank you for the reading of the Psalms. At this time we'll sing a hymn, Act of 239.
Thank you.
seated for our second scripture reading.
Second reading is taken from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 to 5. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain. For the law, the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." This is the word of the Lord.
At this time, I would like to hear your eulogy from the family. After your eulogy, will be followed by special remarks and tributes by Mrs. Fatima Owudu and Professor Martin Agaf. So I'd like to call on the family, being represented by Mr. Weshi Uche Arinze, to come and give us your eulogy.
Good evening, everybody. You're welcome. And I'm glad all of you are here to mourn the family. My brother, Daniel Wally, was born January 1, 1955, in Local Government Area of Plateau State. He started his early education in St. Felix, where he stayed until the Nigerian Civil War. When the Civil War ended, I had the fortunate opportunity to all of us to come back to Asaba, and that's where we met the first time. Because I was east and he was in the north. We all gathered and started back in the SPC Asaba for our secondary school. When we finished, I went west and he went east. He went out to Baraka to play for, if you guys remember, play soccer for the Sharks football club of Otago. He wanted to be a footballer. That's where he stayed. Until the wave of all of us coming to America, everybody was going west. Every time you turn around, somebody's leaving. So I left first and came to the United States. Stayed in Huntsville, Alabama. And he joined me. We stayed in Huntsville for about a couple of years. He decided to go farther west. He moved up to California, went to school at Pomona College, where he got his degree in accountancy. After he left in California, and I was in Atlanta, I had to call him up one day and said, "Bro, you need to come back so we can reunite." So he moved back to Atlanta. When he got back to Atlanta, he set up his accounting business, which made him so popular in Atlanta. My brother John, I could sit here and talk about him all day. A lot of us are going to miss him. The community is going to miss him. That was the house everybody come to eat. You know, you see him in the kitchen cooking sometimes, you wonder who is he cooking for. You know, but by the time he finish, and you turn around, the food is gone. You know, it's like everybody had a key to his house. Everybody had a key to his heart. He never said no to anybody. He was one that give and give and give. He would even give you the last share of his back. Sometimes I just have to tell myself, you can't do this to yourself. Somebody will walk up to him and say, "Can I get a dollar?" He doesn't have it. He will go for the next person and give it to you. That's the kind of person he was. And that's the kind of person I want to remember him for the rest of my life. And I know what security is, men and child, and being, you know, where I was with him. He was special. He's going to be missed. And the family thank all of you coming here today. Please, mourn with us.
Good evening, everyone. I stand here to speak on behalf of the friends of Owechi Jami Awood. I had something written down so I wouldn't lose it. So I'm just going to read it to you. Please bear with me. It's with great sadness but with honor that we all gather to pay tribute to Owechi Nwabinuga Jami Adigwe Awotu. Personally, it's a privilege to have known him as my best friend. Although his time on earth was relatively short, from whatever vantage point and in whatever role we knew him, we can all agree that Owechi Jami lived his life to the fullest. Chief Awodu magnanimously shared his time, talent, and resources to promote many Nigerian diaspora organizations and businesses. He had a gift of innovative thinking and visionary spirit. Many community organizations readily attest to his special leadership abilities and charismatic personality in resolving conflicts and motivating their members in tough times. He was a very passionate man about enabling our communities. Some of us remember Johnny many moons ago
as an Atlanta nightclub owner proprietor who facilitated a community access by hosting African diaspora community events at affordable rates. Some of us present here today, Nico, remember him as an active member of Nico Inc., a Nigerian-owned investment group. Members of his high school alma mater, St. Patrick's College, Asaba, as you heard today, are here to pay tribute to that fallen hero for his contributions in establishing and sustaining their diaspora organization. He's Nigerian and Asaba, and Yoma communities worldwide mourn the passing of their legend of our time. His unparalleled financial contributions as a member of Nigeria's in diaspora organization in the Americas, NIDO, ANOG, and the Nigeria Diaspora Diagnostic and Trauma Foundation, NDDTF, underscore his commitment to diaspora-based efforts towards enhancing the quality of life of the less privileged populations in Nigeria. Owish Joni Awoju will be greatly missed and always remembered for his generosity and intellect. As a brilliant public accountant CPA, U.S. certified tax specialist and community philanthropist, Owish Awoju nurtured and significantly supported many people from all walks of life in meeting their life challenges and the development of their businesses. Many people who may never have been his friends knew Chief Joni as a caring and generous person. But for those of us who were close to him, Owish Joni Awoju was a stubborn, outrageous, tough-talking straight shooter who did not hesitate to call you out and speak out loudly publicly when he disagreed with you. However, Owish Joni Awoju was above all full of heart, an incredibly gifted, goal-oriented person who loved life and all that it offered. Through Joni fought a brave and prolonged strong battle against cancer. Though he lost his war for life, Joni had previously won many battles. Joni had more than 9 lives, believe me. He survived a ghastly accident where he was cut out of the car, pronounced dead, and on the way to the morgue, he woke up. He lived with congestive heart failure, with pacemaker and defibrillator in his body. And he had other things that we don't talk about now, but you know, Uche Arinze and I, we always kidded, reminded him that he outlived millions of people every day he woke up. Because for one of those illnesses, a whole village would have been wiped out. But he just laughed about it and said, well, you know, I'm different, I'm special. He was indeed a strong fighter, always so upbeat, despite his obvious aches and pains. He knew he was in pain, but he just smiled. But he boldly explored treatment options that successfully bought him more time with us. Though Owish Joni Awoju has passed away, our collective memories of him will be our treasure. It is comforting to know that he will always be with us in our hearts. He will never be forgotten by those of us who were fortunate enough to have known him. Thanks, Joni, for bringing us together every weekend to eat, drink, watch football, basketball, whatever you call it, pay-per-view TV. His house was the gathering point. People came there and one guy said, oh, what's happening to my pot of soup? Well, he said, the pot of soup is not going to be there for you. But that's the kind of person Joni was. Thank you for the music and the joy you generously share with all of us. We gathered today to say goodbye to a friend who was genuinely one of life's good guides and who will always be with us. I read somewhere that a friend is a brother your heart chose for you. For me, Owishi Mwabinoga Joni Adigwe Awoju will always be my friend. He has completed his assignment.
During his last days on earth, Johnny prayed so hard and very often with all the prayer groups. Everybody that came there prayed with him. He became a born-again Christian and received even the last of sacraments from the Roman Catholic priest. Indeed, he was at peace with the divine wish of our Lord God. It is our hope and prayer that Johnny rests in divine peace. May you so rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
Before I bring a few words of comfort and hope, I'd like us to sing the second hymn, Blessed Assurance. May you stand as we sing Blessed Assurance, Jesus is coming.
And for those of you that don't have the program, the words will be on the monitors, just by the word.
Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood.
Oh Lord, take our hearts and our minds and use it now for your glory, to encourage your people, to give them a sense of hope. Help the bereaved family tonight to understand that their brother, their father, their husband has not died into oblivion, but that he has entered into the very presence of God, because death is the gateway into the very presence of God. So encourage them tonight, dry up your tears, fill them with hope, and help them to be comforted tonight. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you tonight. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Waykeeping is not always a time to preach. I'm going to just say a few words, just encourage the Bergen family and friends and colleagues that have gathered tonight to share this incredible loss to the Anioma community, to Asaba community, to the Nigerian Oranta community, to all of us who are friends and comrades of Chief Johnny Awudu. We have heard from friends, we have heard from family members, we have heard from colleagues about the extraordinary man and leader Johnny was. Please, can you all keep it very quiet, please? He was very kind, we heard. He was very generous, we heard. He was at ease with friends and with the people around him. His people loved him and he loved them back. He was a great man, a visionary, a committed Nigerian leader who supported with his blessings so many Nigerian community projects here in Atlanta. He was an outstanding figure and leader in our midst. He was passionately committed to whatever he wanted to do. So I personally sympathize with the family, with the Awudu family tonight, and with all the friends that have gathered to share this loss, to encourage the family, to give them hope, and to help them to dry their tears about the passing into glory of their beloved father and friend. I personally sympathize as well with the Asaba community and with the Anioma community here in Atlanta and worldwide about this passing of this illustrious son of Asaba and, of course, Nigeria. He was a unique man and a great leader we have. My prayers are with you tonight, and I pray that God will touch you tonight and comfort you as you keep tonight and hear words of encouragement and words of hope from friends and families that gather here tonight. Yes, death is a wrenching and painful loss. His demise, however, reminds us of all of our mortality, that none of us on this planet, none of us on this earth will live forever. While we are here, we must endeavor to make positive impact to society, to our families, to communities around us, to the world in which we have been born into. We must strive towards doing good, because life is a vapor, the Bible says. As I go around the nations and officiate waykeepings and memorial services and burial services and all that, there are threatens that Lord, I just want to share that quickly as I conclude my words of hope and encouragement tonight. Threatens have always come. In every situation I conduct waykeeping services, burial services or memorial services, I learned three things. One, that death is a time to honor the person It is an opportunity to appreciate what he did before he passed. It is an opportunity to appreciate and affirm the value of his life. As you hang around tonight and listen to friends and people who knew him very well, you will be hearing so many positive things, so many lives he touched, so many things he did to support our community, support his family, and build the life that God has called him to do. So it is the time to honor. And that's what we have come here tonight, to honor his life, to celebrate his life, to celebrate his achievements, the exemplary life he lived, his commitment to friends and to our communities and to his family. So let us tonight do all we can to honor him, to give him his due respect, to pay him his due respect by honoring his life, his extraordinary life. Secondly, we come here to be healed, to be healed. We come here to hear those words of hope and encouragement and hug from our friends so we can comfort each other, comfort the bereaved family, comfort one another, and help them to dry their tears. And whisper to their ears and to their eyes that their brother is now at rest, that is in heaven, where there is no more sickness or death. He battled cancer. Right now he's in heaven, where there is no longer sickness, according to Revelation chapter 21. He's actually looking down from heaven and actually having so much sympathy for us that still live in this sin, diseased, wicked, evil world. He's in the very presence of God Almighty, because dying for a Christian, for a man of God, a woman of God, death is an entrance, it is a gateway into the very presence of God. Paul says, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. Paul preferred to die, to be in the very presence of God, and to live in a world where he still is good dead, where he suffered, where he was imprisoned and beaten, and where he went through all kinds of sickness and disease. But at the same time, life is a beautiful thing. The Bible says life is an unspeakable gift from God. God has given us life to live, to make impact, to be impactful, to be productive, to be creative, to be innovative, to procreate. When Adam and Eve were created, God blessed them as they be fruitful and multiply and procreate. That's what we are here for, not to fight and to be envy and jealous and fight each other and destroy each other. We are here to make impact, to give our very best to our society. But we come here tonight to have the opportunity to really get this Owodu family, to comfort them, to help the bereaved family, help the bereaved community to know that Johnny is now in a better place. Finally, we come to have hope. To have hope. Because one day we will meet with Johnny in heaven. Christ died and resurrected so that we can then be resurrected with him. Christ says, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who die will live. Time of death allows us the opportunity to look at the hope we have in Christ, because Christ conquered death. Death is no longer a mystery. There really is a glorious thing. When we are about to have a child, we start making preparation to buy all the things we need to welcome this new life, new child into the world. It's the same thing we should be doing when we are born. We have to make a preparation to meet our very God in heaven. And the only way we meet God is through death. That's where we meet him. That's where we encounter God. In the very presence of God, we are ushered through death into the very presence of God. Unless some of you will leave when Christ returns, unless Christ comes back tomorrow, but we are all going to die. Death is inevitable. It is inescapable. We cannot escape it. All we are trying to do is to live the best of our time when we have life. Because life flies quickly. It's like vapor. So we come to have hope, to proclaim the hope that is in Jesus Christ, because Christ has conquered death. And it is okay to mourn. title actually tonight is Let Us Not Grieve Like People Without Hope. It is okay to grieve, to mourn, to cry. There are benefits of crying and tearing up and such things. There is benefits in mourning. But I do not want you, especially the word from it, to mourn for a long time. I want you to be comforted tonight. I want you to have hope. I want you to know that one day you will meet your brother in heaven, that your brother has not entered into the very presence of God, where there is no more cancer, sickness, or disease or anything. He's in a very, very comfortable place in heaven. So it is okay to mourn, but do not mourn for a long time. Even though mourning and crying and weeping brings healing to our very soul and eyes, they do not mourn. And do not grieve like someone without hope. In this Advent season, as we plan to prepare and receive the birth of Christ, who was actually born to suffer and to die for the sins of man, let us enter into this period, into this season, with sovereign reality that Jesus Christ has conquered death, and we have hope that John will one day resurrect to be with God in this eternal kingdom. So let us put our trust in God tonight, who is the Prince of Peace, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He is the ornament of life. He is the very Lord of light and Lord of love. May He wash your souls with His cleansing water tonight. May He dry your tears with His love tonight. May He give you grace and comfort you that journey is in a better place. I pray that you put your faith and put your hope on God tonight. Rest in Him because it's faithful. He has conquered death and John is in a better place. So take heart and be strong and know that He has departed. He's sick. This is wicked and wounded world in order to be with the Lord. He has entered into an everlasting glory where there is no more pain, no more sorrow, and no more death. May God dry your tears and fill you, all the worthy family, all the friends, all the comrades, all the friends who have come here tonight, fill each and every one of us with hope that one day we will see Johnny again in heaven. May God bless you all tonight. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. At this time we have a special prayer for the departed soul that will be led by Reverend Father Paul.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Dear friends, it was our Lord Jesus Christ Himself who said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest." Let us pray then for our brother Johnny Adigwe Awodu, that he may rest from his labors and enter into the light of God's eternal Sabbath rest. Amen.
Amen.
Receive, O Lord, your servant, for he returns to you.
Into your hands, O Lord.
Wash him in the holy font of everlasting life and clothe him in his heavenly garment.
In your eyes, O Lord, we command our brother.
May he hear your words for invitation. Come, you blessed of my Father.
In your eyes, O Lord.
May he gaze upon you, Lord, face to face, and taste the blessedness of perfect rest.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend our prayer.
May angels surround him and saints welcome him in peace. Almighty God, our Father in heaven, before whom we live and die, we ask you to receive our brother Johnny and Igwe Awolu into the court of your heavenly dwelling place. Let his heart and soul now ring out in joy to you, O Lord, the living God, and the God of those who live. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Even so, it is.
that by observing 1 minute of silence.
Peace and love.
to be with us this night as we are about to conclude this part one and begin the celebration of Janet's life. We ask you to lead us, to guide us. And at the conclusion of our stay here, may you also lead us home in peace, safety, and good health. And this is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet.
Sure benefits of your son's
saving passion, and glorious resurrection. That in the last day, when we are sung saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when you gather up all things in Christ, we may, with them, and especially with Johnny Adigwe Owudu, enjoy the fullness of your promises. We ask this in the powerful, precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And they will say, Amen. The grace together, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Johnny Adigwe, rest in peace. Amen.
Generally used as a medium of communication
with our God, of course our forefathers, and also a many pray to welcome friends to our home, and under normal circumstances we will be asking for special blessings as we are going to be doing this evening. But in this case, it is done a little differently. The worship better. And I think I can see it better.
Thank you, Mr. MC. Thank you very much, Mr. MC. And I am going to do the traditional breaking of the coconut, and I want to implore you and ask you to please pay attention to the breaking of the coconut. Also, I'm going to speak in my native language because Ojiade and Oyibo. So I'm going to speak in my Sabanese language. Even Ojia Biano, when I say Ojia, anything I say, just say, he said means Amen. When I say it in English or Hebrew, just say, he said. Ojia Biano, Aika Abino, Omi Pege Nani,
he said.
America, why you buy it in America? I don't say I need a
loan.
One man, you want to put in about you. But where is your father? No, God. I got some on that and go back. See you, he said, Brody, I got a deal. What makes you want me? Wanda, let you go, Wanda. What's wrong with Wanda? If I put it out like that, I'm going to pay for one money. I used to sell money. Was a money. I get to keep my money. I got to have a money. I get sick of that. I took one that I'm defending. Can I find Jesus?
Big hand of applause for a question. It's not easy. And all the members of the committee of friends will just give you a front here, if you don't mind. And I will need you to clear this table. I will put the African column on the other side. Ladies and gentlemen, again I welcome you. Very shortly we're going to be having dinner. And after dinner we're going to, of course, have other programs, especially the first funeral remains by the Biru family. But as I welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, all the different communities here, I especially welcome those of you that just heard and came. Because Johnny is a very accomplished person. Even if the Bible says that if you attain the age of 70, you have longevity, but Johnny achieved a whole lot at that tender age. So ladies and gentlemen, tonight we're going to celebrate the life and achievements of this wonderful man. I wish and even I would. At this point in time, as the coconut is being passed around again, I would like to welcome you again and call my DJ to give an interlude of music. And very shortly, I'll be coming back with my co-MC, Prince Abuda. DJ Tony, please.
Bossa, come on.
I'm gonna make you mine. Jesus.
Oh,